Howdy folks, Todd here with Great Escape Farms. Today I am showing you the Cornelian cherry. Actually, in the past I've shown you how to harvest the fruit here. Today I'm going to show you what to do with the fruit once it's harvested. So we're going to use it for kombucha. My wife actually made some jam and made thumbprint cookies with it. And we don't show that here today. We show a little bit of the process. In the future, we'll show that video because those turned out wonderful. These have a nice sour taste to them and they go great for something like butter cookies to give a sour on top of the sweetness. And look at all these seed down here. So I'm going to pull some of these up and see if I can grow them out as well. So let me go ahead and show you what I'm doing with them.
Okay, here's our tray. Put my hand here just to give you an idea of the size here and everything. And we are going to put it on a scale here. And we have probably about a little over 5.5 pounds of fruit here. It says 5.8, but I gotta count a little bit for the bowl here. It's cheap metal, thin metal, but I count a little bit for that. So, well, I have a guest appearance from my wife here today, who is camera shy, but her hands aren't, I'm told. So she's gonna show us how to clean these up.
Okay, so what I do is I put the cherries in a bowl and just fill them with cold water. And if you stir them around with your hand, all the little debris and stuff comes to the top, so you can float off the major chunks and the little branches and stuff. And then after that, I just strain a little bit of it out. And then I take the cherries by hand and lean them over a bowl and just poke the seed out on its own and then throw the flesh in another bowl. Sometimes it's easier than others. And of course, now that Todd's filming me, it's not going to be easy, but that is our daughter Molly in the background crying because she's not getting attention in the kitchen. But this is just how I do it. And because it takes such a long time, I spread out on a beach towel in the living room in front of the TV and put a movie in and just sit there and mindlessly pit these things so that we can make something with it later.
So my bride finished up and she set aside 4 cups here for a jam that she's gonna make so she can make cookies. And this is left for me right here. So we're gonna puree this up, or I should say she offered to puree it up in the, I think she said Vitamix, in a blender or something like that, and get all the chunks out, and then I will use this for kombucha. And here's the seeds, and I'll do a separate video on this. Well, I'll go ahead and plant these, and it's probably be a couple year long video because these things take a long time to germinate. So look for that in, say, 2026 or so. Okay, we are all blended up. It is quite thick, so I'm gonna use a spoon here, and we are going into an old style ice cube tray here. And we are gonna level this off and we're gonna freeze it up. This would probably be a little easier if we mixed it with some water, but I'm not sure what I'm gonna be using all of this for. So I didn't want to be mixing water or anything else with it. So I know I'm going to be using it for kombucha or fermented tea. And again, I'll do that in a separate video. But what I'll do is I will take this ice cube tray, put it in the freezer, and then after a day or two, I will take the ice cubes out, put them in a 1 gallon plastic bag labeled. And then I have these things all winter long to use as I see fit. So I just went ahead and labeled this Cornelian Cherry 2024 and I pulled these out and they will come out easily. Unfortunately, I don't have my tripod with me, so I'm gonna have to do this in steps for you. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fold this bag halfway inside out. So let me do that and I'll show you. Okay, so I folded it. I folded the outer part out, or the top part out. So the inside, it's kind of folded in on itself here, and I loosened these up, and hopefully I can get some out. Ah, it fell out on me. Anyhow, they are beautiful little ice cubes here. I can use them in whatever I'm making. In this case, I'm gonna do kombucha, so I'm gonna go ahead and empty all these guys in the freezer bag here, and then I'll put the freezer bag back in the freezer. This allows me to have sized units that are frozen, and they won't really clump together. They might just a little bit, but they're easy enough to separate apart. And here we are, all set to go. So I have, what is that? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and I think I had 8, so about 22 cubes. Just shy of 2 dozen in here, ready to go. So seal this up and put it in the freezer, and I'm ready to make kombucha. So thank you very much for tuning in. Please keep an eye out for our other videos. So I'll have one on seeds. My wife's going to make jam and possibly do one on that. And then I'll do one on kombucha here. So those will be coming out later this year. Thank you very much for tuning in and have a great day.